Good morning, students. Nous allons voir la suite de la grammaire, leçon numéro 4. So, we are going to follow the grammar of the lesson number 4. Last few hours, what we saw? We saw the animal snail, isn't it? And the expression with avoir. Okay, so now you are going to take your grammar part and you are going to follow the grammar that I am going to teach you. Vous avez appris aujourd'hui l'interrogation. So we are going to see the interrogation form. Okay, so what are the three forms of interrogation? You have the intonation and you have using SFE, do you? Or you have the inversion form. So you are going to see step by step what are the form that we are following for the interrogation form. Okay, so les trois formes d'interrogation, the three forms of interrogation sentence. L'intonation. So we are going to use the intonation form to raise the voice. Okay, so do you speak French? So you can see the changes of my voice. Okay, so we are going to raise our intonation question form. Okay, so I've given you some examples here. By using raising the intonation, vous parlez français. So you speak French. Next one, tu regardes la télé. You watch TV. So it's an affirmative sentence. So normal sentence asked in a question pattern. Okay, so it is an intonation form. Tu ne regardes pas la télé. So you can see my voice. Don't you? You don't watch TV? Okay? So this is the intonation form. Next form, what is that? Est-ce. So using est-ce and using est-ce with the apostrophe for E and L. Okay? If you have a vowel subject, so you are going to use cut the E and add Q apostrophe. U apostrophe. Okay? That is mean by do you or is that. Okay? So, before an affirmative or a negative sentence, we are going to place before or an affirmative sentence or a negative sentence. So, est-ce que vous parlez français? Est-ce que vous parlez français? So, do you speak French? Okay? So, the next sentence is ne regarde pas le match. So, don't he watch the match? Okay, so est-ce ne regarde pas. So, you can see the negative form sentence, isn't it? Okay, so here you have the affirmative sentence. Here you have a negative sentence using est-ce. So, next format, what is that? Inversion form. So, we are going to inverse the subject and the verb. Okay, so the pronoun. By inverting the verb and the pronoun. So the pronoun is the pronoun, subject pronoun. And inserting a hyphen. So we are going to insert an hyphen in between the verb and the pronoun. So let me see some examples. Parlez-vous français? So, parlez-vous français? Do you speak French? Okay, so it's the same meaning, but in French we are going to inverse the subject and the verb. But in English we have the same meaning. Do you speak French? Okay, so ne regardes-tu pas la télé? So don't you watch TV? So you have the negative form. Ne regardes-tu pas la télé? So don't you watch TV? Okay, so inversion form sentence asking a negative form. So next one, regardes-tu la télé? So the same as we saw for the first one. Regardes-tu la télé? So do you watch TV? Okay, so this is fine for you. Did you understand the intonation form, est-ce form and inversion form? So we have three formats to use the interrogation sentence. Okay, so now we are going to see a small note. So that is the in the third person of singular form. So what is that? He or an. So third form of singular. or the, then T is inserted. Okay, so if we are doing an inversion, we are going to have E or N. So we are going to insert a small T in between the verb and the pronoun. Okay, so Pangalji Fonse. Does he speak French? So Pangalji Fonse. Next one. Regarde-t-il la télé? Does he watch TV? Regarde-t-il la télé? So you have a negative sentence. You are using the inversion form using il. So ne regarde-t-il pas la télé? Don't he watch the TV? Okay. So you can see the difference between this one and this one. So for il, you are going to insert a T. Okay, if the verb does not end with T or D, we are going to insert T. If it ends with D or D, so no need to insert a T again. Okay, so be careful if you have exercise regarding this. So you have to see the verb ending. Then only you have to see whether you have to insert a T or D for the subject in or am. Okay, it's not for the other subject. So, inversion form is not used for the subject je. So, if you have a sentence, je comprends la leçon. I understood the lesson. So, what will be the intonation form? Je comprends la leçon or tu comprends la leçon. Next one, est-ce que je comprends la leçon or est-ce que tu comprends la leçon? Or inversion form, we are not going to use the inversion form for the subject je. Okay, so it is clear for you, I think. Okay, so this is the three format to see the interrogation form. So now we are going to see l'interrogation négative AC. So we already saw interrogation form in a negative form. What is that? Subject plus ne plus verb plus pas. Okay, so now we are going to see in the third form of a negative interrogative sentence, the ne is placed, the pa is placed before, after the subject. Okay, so ne parlez-vous pas français? So don't you speak French? So here we have interrogation the pa. Okay, the pa is placed after the subject. Okay, so in a negative form also, ne regarde-tu pas la télé? So you can see pa is placed after the subject in a inversion form in the negative sentence. Okay, so now we are going to see, we already know how to answer that question. Yes or no? In French is oui ou non. Okay, so S is oui, no is no. Okay, so there is another way to say yes. So in French we have si. Si, it is to trust, yes. Okay, so if you are deciding with a negative question using by si. So I am going to give you some example, explain you. Vous ne parlez pas français? So don't you speak French? So you're going to say yes, I speak French. So because you are already speaking French. If you have a positive question asking a negative form, okay, so you are positive, but the question will ask in a negative form. You're going to trust yourself. You're going to say yes. Okay, so that is C. Si, je parle français. So if you are among your friends, so your friends will ask you, do you speak English? Yes, I speak English. You are going to say to them, okay? So next one, ne regarde-t-il pas la télé? Don't they watch TV? Don't he watch TV? Si, il regarde la télé. Okay, so ne regarde-t-il pas la télé? Si. So I hope you will understand the question answered with C, the referring this grammar. So go through this grammar one more time and then do the assignment, given assignment. Thank you. Merci.